are closed, and those who drink this water will be brought to eternal life.
Today is also our official launch of our mission statement, so I'd really like everyone, although we say lots of nice fine words here, on the last page you will see the mission statement, which is for our twin parishes, one of which is St. Margaret Mary's and also Our Lady of the Sacred Heart. This took 1 year, and a lot of you, most of you in fact here, participated in this in one way or another. Consultant. And the result is, it's a beautiful result. It talks about family, it talks about young people, it talks about care for the people who are marginalized. So it really speaks to the values of the Catholic Church, as well as the special values that we have and that we think are important in our two twin parishes. So I do want to mention that's very important, which is this is now our guiding light. And then we said, well, look, we know a person who is absolutely dedicated to the restoration of churches, who has a very strong faith, and he had done a little bit of work for us before, and we turned to him in our need, and he really stepped up to the plate and did an amazing job in a very short period of time. So I'd like everyone, if we could welcome, and we'd like to say a few words and thank John O'Brien, our architect.
Gracious words, Bob, and Bishop Bishop, Father John, the other priests. And most of all, it came together because it was founded on prayer. A lot of prayer went into making sure that this was successful, and I think that's probably the matrix that brought it all together. We must thank the tradesmen, as Bob had mentioned, to look at just quickly mention some of these who worked so hard. For heaven's sake, those pews that went in and out of the church so many times, they actually devised a system of skateboards. The pews that put the pews on skateboards out the front,
It was incredible.
But it's resilience. And we must thank the man stores for the wonderful work. Demetrius and Danny, who did all the paint removal and repainting. Wolfgang and John with the glorious stained glass. Danny, the electrician. Raymond, the renderer up there, 15 metres up. Paul Hoffman, who did a wonderful job on the pond, honestly, backwards and forwards so many times. And that was absolutely glorious, Raymond. Engelbert, who did a beautiful hand carved statue of Mother Mary McKillop. John from Miraflores, Bruce, who cleaned the church with a vacuum cleaner, which is there on the right. The Sydney planning professionals who did work externally, Ron Conrad and the team who repaired the roof, and we're still up there on the roof, that's another story. David Peace with the organ, Nick and Pete with the plastering, and David Pons with the carpeting. Stephen and Michael, they did a really beautiful job on the artworks. That's very, very well done. Harry from Mediterranean Marble, did the work on the font and also on Mother Mary McKillop's shrine. Rick from Sandstone Artists, who did the sandstone work. And then people like Peter James, Brett, who worked with us, Newtown Electrics, and many others. And of course, Jacqueline. Coming back to that story of being completely out of my depth, okay, there's a lot of work on, but it didn't worry me, because that's where our Lord wants us to be, completely out of our depth.
And finally, the third thing, I thank you, Peter, because you make the parish. You are the, we are the church, aren't we?
Yes.
We are the church, and this is us, and we want beautiful things. Two, to worship God. We want to sing beautifully to worship God and to draw us together. And what you do is you make community happen. So we're in a unique place in town, and it's a passing parade for a lot of things too. So somewhere they have a heart. A heart is a big thing, and you give the heart this space. So thanks, dear people. Love you very much. And I'm very proud today for that church.
Built the church, and I gave the ideas, and
actually is the one that gave all the money.